music is one of the most direct ways to access somebody's emotion, to access someone's heart. You know, I mean, like, you hear music, and a lot of times it doesn't even need to have words attached to it. It's just you're moved by music that connects with your soul, you know. And I think that's why it's one of the best tools to express our worship to our Creator. I mean, we're created for God. We're created by God. We're created to worship God. And yes, you can worship God in every single aspect of your life. But something special happens when you gather people together and you begin singing to God. Something, I don't know what it is. I don't know where to find it in Scripture. I know all throughout Scripture it says, sing to the Lord, sing praises to the Lord. Lift up a shout,
everybody cry out. When I auditioned for the music department, I became well aware that the music that they do and the music that I do didn't really fit all that well at that point in time. And so I wasn't accepted into the music program. And so I was crushed. I was thinking, man, I'm not going to be a worship leader anymore. And so I majored in psychology.
When I got here, really kind of dove in and helped the youth ministry, the high school student ministry, and led worship there and really kind of poured my life into that. And the children's ministry, we have this amazing production for our children at our church, and really helped shape the music for that. And that's been a joy and a privilege to be a part of that. And just to see God's hand at work in the life of our church has been unbelievable. I mean, He's grown the church. He's expanded the influence of what we're doing. And I know, you know, to some people, we're kind of new on the scene here. And we would seem like a new band, just, you know, fresh band, just getting started. But we've been doing what we've been doing for a long time. I know I have. I've been leading worship for over 12 years now. And the cool thing about leading worship with these guys is that it's just not, we don't just come together to go, you know, out of town and play music and then come back and we don't see each other again until we play again. We're doing life together. We are in ministry together at our church. It's a very cohesive thing.
And let these songs just go and equip the church to have these massive things to say from us to God. And I've seen those guys do that. So the song, All Because of Jesus, it's funny. I wrote the verses of that song years and years and years ago, and I could never come up with anything. And so you know, the verse talks just about how sufficient God is and how faithful He is to provide for us. It says, giver of every breath I breathe, author of all eternity, giver of every perfect thing. And it was just while we were just beginning our recording process where we came up with the chorus. And you know, the chorus says, it's all because of Jesus that I'm alive. It's all because the blood of Jesus Christ covers me and raised this dead man's life. And those two concepts just fit together by saying Jesus is so, I mean, our God is so sufficient and He's so provisional over our lives. And the chorus just says it's all because of Him that we're even alive today. And not just alive breathing air, but alive in our hearts, like alive spiritually forever. And those just kind of fit together and we're like, hey, the song's done. This is beautiful. One song in particular that we get to watch kind of unfold as we play it is a song, Glorious One. A lot of people have said to us, kind of just by way of encouragement about the song, is that it's like, you know, it's the first time I've ever heard this song, but it seems like I've known this song my whole life, you know? And I don't attribute that to good songwriting. I attribute that to God already having putting that confession in us to say to Him, you know, there's a line in the song that says, there is none more beautiful and there is no one more wonderful. You know, I mean, that seems like what you want to say to the Lord when you're before Him. You want to say, of all the things in the world, of all the things in the universe, there is nobody that compares to you. I've got a lot of musical influences.
To people like Celine Dion, Josh Groban,
yeah.
Of course. I would say definitely Boy George.
Bill Gaither.
Bill Gaither has been massive. I mean, I think if you listen to our CD, you'll hear all four of those. It's like a perfect, mm-hmm. like a perfect mix of all four of those people.
I think our generation's been influenced by the sounds of like U2 and Coldplay. I think that's kind of a given. But there's a, you know, Delirious, Martin Smith. Those guys are unbelievable musicians, and they, like, I listen to their records, and I think to myself, that's kind of how I want to sound when I say something to God, because they're singing something that connects with me, but they're also singing these words that connect us to the heart of God. And so I love hearing songs that move me musically, but also move my heart spiritually and say, this is in me already to say to God, and I want to join in.